Once again, we're going to be moving to the bottom of the first inning. And for you folks watching on WRMG TV 12 and TV 97, Belgreen got one run in the top of the first inning. They lead 1-0. We're going to move to the bottom of the inning now. This is JV action. We got, of course, time limit on this one. And we'll see how the Red Bay Tigers do here in the bottom of the first inning. Can you read this writing? Do you know that pitcher on the mound? Third one in there. That is Archer. Okay. That's what I called it, but I started second guessing myself. That makes me feel good if you got some good young ones coming up. Are you going to hope? Are you going to hopefully stay involved when Annalise heads over to Northeast somewhat? We need you to. I know Annalise's ball games will be number one, but we still need you to. Do me a favor, if you're watching this JV game, make sure you share this link with your friends out there. I know we got some folks that may not know this broadcast is on the air. So if you'll share it for us, we surely would appreciate it. Archer ready to go. And this is Brittley Harden now, the batter. And the pitch on the way. It's inside. You think Nash would look good with one of those bows in his hair? In his beard, okay. I know Allen would look good on maybe the back of his hat. So I need to go ahead and order a couple of them for the boys. Brittley Harden. Who's leading all the cheers down the dugout? Or Ashley, who? Ashley Blackburn. Oh, Brittley would be leading them. Three balls and no strikes in the pitch, and it's ball four. Kyla Blackburn, the batter here. She's at shortstop today. And the pitch is a strike. I told them on the earlier broadcast that there was a rumor about that building falling in, that you and Blackburn and Nichols was up there messing around doing something up there on top of it, and it fell in. I didn't tell him he was jumping up and down, but I told him y'all was up there. They say ice brought it down. Tell you, that had to be a lot of weight to, I saw where it bent some of those. And the pitch on the way. I got a question. Was that the Chinese trusses, you know, that they import from China? Was it? That's a true story? I was wondering if they were import trusses or not. I was talking about that metal. Where it was metal, looked like. And the pitch. You know, of course, it must have been worse right here because M&S right over here, you know, went down. Did they have any vehicles under theirs? Yes. Oh, they're still under it? And the pitch, swing and a miss for the strikeout. Edgman now the batter. And the pitch is a ball outside. Harden getting some pretty good leads down there. It's getting some looks from the catcher. Red Bay Varsity wins 6-5 in seven innings tonight to go 7-0. And the pitch. Swing right back to the pitcher. Good job, Archer. Throw to first. So two outs. This will bring up Lexi Howard. Two outs for the Tigers here with a runner down at second. That ball gets away. And down at third base is a Red Bay Tigers pitcher. There's a ball. 40 minutes left in the time limit. What's the rule on that? They let the other team bat depending on or
finish the inning.
Yeah,
they'll
finish the inning. So if we're in the middle of the inning, that inning will
finish.
It's not going to happen. What if the team batting was already ahead? They'd just go ahead and stop it. Two balls, one strike, two out. Runner at third base, two out. Red Bay batting with no. Well, let's see. 1-0 the score. I had to think about that. If you're watching on Facebook Live or our TV replay, you see the score is 1-0. And the pitch is low and outside, ball four. So Edgman draws a walk, or Howard draws a walk, I should say. Ava Osalt, the batter. Does Ava like that catcher position?
She does.
And the pitch. Runner stealing there. Guess who had watching earlier tonight? I don't know how long you watched. The world famous coach, Dr. Ricky Ford. Yeah, he watches us a bunch. One strike count. Swing and a shot to the right side. That one could be trouble. It's in there for a hit. That scores a run. Two runs. And down at second base, standing up with a double. That shows you right there when that ball is hit, you need to be on the run because you never know. Ava Olsalt gets a two-banger there to drive in a couple of runs, and that will bring in Michaela Young. We're going to have a courtesy runner. Natalie Stanfield, is that correct, did you say? So Michaela Young got a sister that's a senior on this team, eh, Mackenzie? You wouldn't know that they're sisters by looking at them, would you? Or even throw their mama in the same ring. And the pitch on the way. It's a ball. Red Bay's taking a 2-1 lead. 36 minutes left in the time limit. And a swing and a foul ball to the right side by Young. Stanfield, the courtesy runner, is saying, Michaela, come on, get us a hit. Drive me in. And the pitch, swing and a foul tip back to the screen. Swinging a round ball to the shortstop. She bobbles it. Runner over at third now, and the runner down at first. And, of course, I'd have my hands full by the time she hit that. I was going to try to check out another score. There you go. She grounded that ball to the shortstop out there, and just a little bobble is all that was needed. So now runners at first and third with two outs. Got a left-handed batter here. Caleb Milam. And the ball outside. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a foul tip. I know that's a noisy bunch down there in the dugout, isn't it? Can you hear them? I'm going to let you hear them. Listen, y'all listen in. Well, I turn the mic up and they stop. One ball, one strike, and two out. Red Bay scored two here in the bottom of the first to take the lead, and Milam swings and misses. That'll make it one ball, two strikes. Milam is ready to go. The pitch. That one just misses. Red Bay's got runners at second and third. Deuce is wild on this one. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Red Bay leads 2-1, bottom of the first. JV action. Swing and a foul tip. I thought he called a foul, but and it is a foul tip. So everybody's got to go back. So Milam has new life. Is it two balls, two strikes? Is that right? Hey, Blue, what's the count? 2-2? Thank you, sir. Two balls, two strikes. There's Harold Strickland checking in with us. And a swing and a shot to the left side. Going to be foul. Red Bay softball team wins tonight 6-5 in seven innings. Score two in the last at bat. There's a base hit by Chloe Knobloch. Drives in the tie and go-ahead run and the winning run. Red Bay baseball team lost tonight 15-0 down at Seligen. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. But the Tigers, even though they strand some runners, they pick up a couple and take the lead right now. The Red Bay Tigers lead by a score of 2-1. See Mama Blackburn down there telling them to get out of the dugout and get in the field. 2-1 the score. This is live coverage of JV softball on WRMG TV 12. Joseph Boyd checking in with us. You know the coach Joseph Boyd, don't you? Former stump man for the Red Bay Tigers. Mac Neville and Williams with us out there tonight. Isabella Fowler checking in with us. Batting here in the top of the second inning is Bell Green, JV, and the Harden pitch. A little low. Good stop there by the catcher. Number 15, the batter. This is Fisher, Tate on deck, followed by Tompkins. And the pitch, low and in the dirt. Red Bay leads right here 2-1. There's 29 minutes left in the time limit. Red Bay plays Russellville here Thursday night. They will be in Russellville playing a couple of games Friday and Saturday. Do you know the opponents over there yet? Or? We'll find out here. Two strikes the count to the batter with one out. And the pitch, swing and a foul. Haleville and Wilson on Friday. Saturday to be determined. Two balls and two strikes. And the pitch on the way, swing and a pop foul. Yeah. And the 2-2 pitch, strike three call. Good job by Brittley Harden on the mound pitching for the Red Bay Tigers. And the batter here is number 17. This is Tate, the right fielder batting. Red Bay, as you see on your screen, leads 2-1. We're at the top of the second inning. And the pitch. And the pitch is a strike call. And there's a strike. Two balls, two strikes, and one out. And there's a little chop to the right side foul. Once again, 17, Tate moved over to the right side here. And the pitch, swing and a miss. Strike out there for Harden. Let's bring up number 21. This is Tompkins, the batter. That was a low one in the dirt. Appreciate Jason Bolton out there with us, along with Jimmy Sims. Robert Newell, Mac Neville, and Williams out there. And there's another strikeout by Harden. And we're going to go to the bottom of the second inning. The Red Bay Tigers lead by a score of 2-1. This is live coverage here on WRMG. Brought to you by some really, really great sponsors like H.W. Watson Logging Company, Red Bay Pharmacy, Bill and Donna Weatherford, Brandon Nunley Construction Company on our broadcast here today as well. Also, a big shout-out today to our sponsors, Consider the Lilies, Angie and Ted LeMay, by Allen and Ash Harden, and Harden Heating and Cooling, serving North Mississippi and North Alabama in business now for over 46 years. They have been a factory-authorized York dealer now for many, many years, three generations strong. 356-8913 is the number. Also, a big shout-out to Red Bay Rentals, 5x10, 10x10 climate control, also 5x10 and 10x10 mini storage units. Locks are always free. You got 24-hour access, located at 784 7th Avenue Southwest. Let us store your treasures. Johnny Weatherford at Red Bay Rentals. Also, don't forget Explore Liquidations has moved their showroom and retail operations over to Muscle Shoals, Alabama. More room and room for more bargains. Bloomingdale's, Macy's, 40 West, Amazon, much more, 50 to 75% off. Don't forget tomorrow, Swamp John's Jack Ivy Chicken on a Stick Day. You going to be in town tomorrow? What about a chicken on a stick tomorrow? You better call and order it early, as you know. Oh, Lord. Hey, about a half a dozen of the players said they went out there last Wednesday. Of course, they was out. They said, "You didn't get yours. You was doing a ball game." And I said, "Yeah, I did get mine." I said, "Mine was delivered to the station." I said, "It was waiting on me when I got back from Jackson." And there's a pop to the right side. Right fielder coming over, not going to be able to get to it. It's going to be a foul. When me and my wife had COVID back early November, I was probably out of commission for 3 weeks. I had them delivered to the house every Wednesday. Yeah. I think two or three weeks ago, they had already been up in their quantities. They doubled it again. And the girl said they didn't get a single one today. I think they tried to get it like 10:30. One ball, one strike, nobody out. Red Bay batting here. Who we got batting here, Coach? The world-famous right fielder, number 27, Violet Lancaster. All kinds of personalities on a softball team, aren't they? Who, I'm talking varsity here, okay? Who would be considered the quietest on the varsity roster? Jasmine Pearson has qualified. Her and Hannah Butler. You know, they've done a good job there. Are they pretty young, those two girls? Yeah, they are, what how old are they? That's awesome. So Jasmine out in left field, eighth grader. Ninth grader, Hannah down at second base. And there's a swing and a foul tip. Who's the biggest jokester on the team? Lila and who? Annalise. Now, when the game's on the line, it's all business. It's all business. Those young ladies, they got too much invested. This is a last hurrah for those seniors, of course. Lila being one of the seniors. Annalise is only a junior, but them young ladies got a lot of time. And Chloe and some of the others, the seniors, got a lot of time invested here. Two strikes, the count, and a swing. And that is a strikeout. Gretchen Davis there going down. I think we're back to the top of the batting order here with Brittley Harden. Harden shot to right field. That one's in there for a hit. And runner's going to end up over at third base. Good job, Brittley. We'll show you Miss Harden down at first base here in just a second. We'll have to hurry to be able to get back. There she is right there. Nice hit. And the pitch low. Harden will end up down at second base. Kyla Blackburn, the batter. And the pitch, ball high. Two balls. No strikes. One out. Red Bay leading 2-1. Red Bay threatening with runners at second and third. Just need a Harden hit right here. Swinging a foul tip. Listen to this. Well, I was going to turn it up, and they stopped again. So if I want them to hush, I need to stick my head out the window, swinging them. Oh, she went around. Blackburn the batter. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. It's up to Edgman right here. Gracie, the DH today. And the pitch. Swing and a miss. Who's got the largest set of lungs? Yeah. Emma McAllister. She's the loudest. And the ball gets away, but no runners. Is there a boss to the dugout? All get along? That makes it fun, doesn't it? And the pitch. It's a ball. Edgman the batting now with the runners at second and third. Is that Lancaster down at third? Down at second is Harden. Red Bay leading 2-1 with 15 minutes to go in the time limit. And the pitch on the way. Swing, ground ball to the right side. Second baseman's got it. Throw over to first in time for the out. Tigers strand a couple of runners as Belgreen able to get out of that jam there. We're going to go to the top of the third inning. It's the Red Bay Tigers leading 2-1 over Phil Campbell. This is JV action, all brought to you by the City of Red Bay, Franklin County Probate Judge Barry Moore. Don't forget Alpha Insurance on our broadcast. Miller's Affordable Furniture, Terry and Jason, thank you so much. By State Senator Larry Stutz, Redmont Pharmacy. By Redmont Heating and Cooling with Patrick Brooks, by Alpha Insurance. John Cook, by Baytree Gift Company, the Medical Clinic of Red Bay with Dr. Fabianchi. That great-tasting Carl Lewis sausage by Stadium Pros, Keith Kennedy, Alton Barksdale. The Cardinal Drive-In. What about your Edward Jones agent, Mike Jones? Also, Community Spirit Bank, your hometown bank with hometown solutions since 1908. See Brad and the staff right here in Red Bay. Also, Fastway Car Wash out on Highway 19, home-owned and home-operated. Miss Ann Vinson says, go Tigers! Also, the Deaton Funeral Home of Red Bay and Belmont, serving the area since 1945. Triple D's Bucket Service over in Iuka. They got something to go up about 7 or 8 stories up. Trim trees, remove them. Debris removal, stump grinding, cleaning church steeples, all done in a professional manner. 662-279-7500. Also, Tri-State Insurance. Kim and Caleb Wells, Mike Moore, and Christy Mayo. Don't forget, whether it be insuring your vehicle, your home, motorcycle, four-wheeler, boat, RV, farm, or even a business, they got a policy that can be tailored just for you. Once again, that is Tri-State Insurance right here in Red Bay and over in Belmont. Also, Tiffin Motorhomes on our broadcast here today. Underwood, True Value Hardware, Bay Diesel and Air Conditioning, Chris and Valerie Moore, Dr. Rick Wooten at Wooten Chiropractic, 331-0208. And also want to thank Tiffin Supply, Tiffin Appliance Company on our broadcast. Red Bay Hospital, Miss Sherry Jolly, the Banner Tire Store with Jason Parker. By Ronald Thorne, your State Farm agent. By Dickie Sparks, CPA, Silver Dollar Bargains in Golden. Down in Tupelo in Hamilton, Alabama. The Red Bay Yacht Club's got some brand new hours. Of course, they're closed on Sunday now, but listen to this. They're open Monday through Friday, 7 to 2. They're open Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night, 4 to 8, with great food, entertainment. And, of course, you can call them at 256-333-4438. You can check them out on Facebook or at redbayacres.com. Also, don't forget Albin Mason Construction Company on a broadcast, Mike Engel at Engel Farms, and Jason Miller, your county commissioner for District Number 2. Harden still on the mound for the Tigers, who lead 2-1. And the pitch on the way. Just it's a ball. Not for sure who this battery is here. Red Bay on top, 2-1. That one in the dirt. Don't forget, I told you about Miller's Affordable Furniture on our broadcast here tonight. Buck, Mike Wright. Jason Miller wants to know where I'm going to be tomorrow. I can tell you exactly where I'm going to be tomorrow. About 11 o'clock, Swamp John. Ground ball right back to the pitcher. Throw to first. She's safe off the bag down at first base. Marty Guidry is putting me on the spot. Jack, are those chicken on the sticks as good as the Chevron in Jackson? You know who used to eat them there, don't you? Ogeron. Yeah. Ogeron. I'm going to say yes, because I am very partial to the ones at Swamp John's. They are awesome, Marty. Buck McWright checking us out. And, you know, it's you know they're up there pretty good if they're as good as the Chevron in Oxford. Seems like everything's better in Oxford, though. Yeah. Where is that at? Number six, you better. He said the only thing that might, any place might be better is Tuscaloosa. Years ago, I'm going to teach a management seminar in Clanton, Alabama. And I knew all of them was a bunch of Alabama fans when I got down there and stuff. And I said, boy, I really enjoyed my trip down. I was living in Memphis then. And there's a hit to the right side. Let's see what the first baseman can do. She feels it on first for the out. And I said, you know, since our meeting a little late, I left early, and I said I came through and got a chance to see the campus for the University of Alabama. I said I didn't realize how big Hamilton was. You know, everybody knew about the trade school in Hamilton at the time, so I was saying the University of Alabama was in Hamilton. They said it ain't in Hamilton. I said, well, I'm sorry. I thought that's where I was at. Of course, that didn't go over too good. He told me to go easy on Ogeron. Now, you didn't hear me say anything bad about Ogeron, Marty. He's your hometown hero other than Bobby Hebert. Now, Marty's going to be pleased to know that as we popped it out to left field, good job. Who's that out in left field so I won't have to look it up? Who? Sophie's out there. I've got it right here somewhere. Sophia Strickland. Marty is impressed that I knew it was Bobby Hebert instead of Herbert. Marty, I used to travel Louisiana a bunch, and I used to travel it a bunch. And that ball gets away, and the runner's going to be down there, and now the ball thrown in the outfield. It gets by the left fielder, and that run's going to walk in to tie it up. So we got a tie ball game. There's Barbara Walker-Smith checking in with us. Thank you, Miss Barbara. Hope you're feeling better. Marty, I used to love to go to Prejean's up in Lafayette. And the pitch on the way. There's a lot of good places to eat down there. I know that. Two balls and no strikes, two outs, and the pitch on the way. Swing and a miss. I'm spending the night, of all places, one night, Opelousas. And I had one more call I was going to make, so I went ahead and checked into the hotel. It was going to be in Opelousas where I was going to stay, make the call at. I checked into the hotel and drove around to where my room was going to be, and they had me. I was like on the second floor there, Quality Inn in Opelousas. And I drove around. I'm 400 miles away from home, right? And right where I would park, say my room's up above, it was at Tishomingo County Tag, Mississippi. And I thought, who in the world is down here? And they were there, and they weren't hardly nobody at the hotel when I checked in. And he worked in the garment industry, and you know Sean Wigginton? I think it was his dad, Obi. Obi's working. He did a lot of things with the production on the machines and all that stuff. There's a throw down to first, and she is going to be out down to first base to retire the side. They made it interesting. Folks, we got 7 minutes to go. We're all tied up. And the Red Bay Tigers can win this ball game here in the bottom of the third if they can score a run. Got to hurry. Only 6 minutes to go in the time limit. But he was down there doing work, and me and him went to supper that night. And I carried him over to Prey Jones. Needless to say, I went two nights in a row. I actually ordered the same thing. I mean, it's a really great place to eat. They had live Cajun music. You know, had to, and I ate a dish called Catfish Catahoula. And they had the homemade bread. Man, it was good. It had some kind of like dirty rice and some kind of like little shell, like a corn shell of some sort. And had corn. And corn was in that shell, and that was catfish fillets, kind of like curled up, and it was stuffed with like crab meat and crawfish, and man, oh Lord, it was good. I would drive down there to eat it again. Now, my wife wouldn't eat it, but I would. Marty, I ain't even seen. Marty's probably been there before. There's the world-famous Jackie Hernandez down there. Down in Belmont checking us out. Jackie, how you doing tonight? We've got a good one going here. It is the Red Bay Tigers and the Bell Green Lady Bulldogs. This is JV action. We're all tied up. 2-2. Only 5 minutes to go in the time limit, so. And here's the pitch. It's a ball high. 12 batting for the Tigers. Lexi Howard. I think she's got some of the movements of her sister, Emma. I can see Emma batting down there right now. 1-0 pitch. Outside, ball two. Archer still on the mound pitching. Green behind the plate. And it is now 3 balls and no strikes. Chad Moses checking in with us. Alex Guidry, I'd rather eat my grandma's Cajun cooking than to eat out. Well, Marty and Alex, you're talking about mama's cooking. We got a ball four here. You need to bring me a dish. Now, my wife can't eat it. Burns her mouth or whatever, so she can't eat certain things like that, but Jack Ivy can. So you talk he talks a big Cajun cooking here by mom. Prove it. Philip Rogers said prove it. And the pitch on the way. They don't want to eat out. There's a pop up to the right side. Second baseman is under it, makes the catch. We're down to 3 minutes to go, all tied up 2-2. Now, this is Marty's quote, only Cajun cooking I eat is cooked by my mama. And Alex says, I'd rather eat my grandma's Cajun cooking than to eat out. All tied up. This is JV. By the way, Red Bay Varsity scored 2 runs in the bottom of the 7th to pull out a win over Bell Green. 6-5 was the final score. Red Bay Varsity goes to 7-0. Hats off to the Lady Tigers. One out and a 1-0 count here. And the pitch on the way. Tigers have got a runner on, and now they throw it into right field. And Lexi's got to be safe down at second base. Michaela Young. There's only 2 minutes to go on the time limit. Hope you've enjoyed our coverage here tonight. And the ball gets away. Red Bay's going to end up with a run over at third base. I got a question. If the clock goes out here, do we get to finish batting? So we're going to finish this inning regardless. 1 out, 3 balls and no strikes. Red Bay with a winning run. Down at third base. And the pitch on the way. Foul ball. Ain't it been beautiful this week? Man. So how's it going to be? I know it's overcast, supposed to be about Friday or so, but is the temperature supposed to stay pretty warm? I don't know where I can stand it. Mid-70s pretty much all week. 3-1 count, the pitch on the way. Swing and a foul back. Good cut by Young. When's the best chance of rain coming? So none this week, right? So nothing this week, so I don't have to carry an old raincoat tomorrow. 3-2, 1 Red Bay's got the winning run at third base. The pitch on the way. Young, slow roller to the right side. That run's coming in, and the Tigers are going to win the ball game by a score of 3-2. Do what now? They're going to finish out this inning. So you're saying if they get this out, they would let them hit again before this? What if he called a timeout right now? Yeah, right now would be a perfect time for a timeout. So Red Bay leads 3-2. There's 35 seconds to go. There's only one out. I don't think they can get two outs that quick. 28 seconds to go. I guess I better put this score up there. So I jumped the gun a little bit, but looks like Red Bay is going to win. 3-2 Red Bay. There's the pitch. Outside. We're down to 10 seconds. So we're definitely not going to play another inning. 4 seconds. 1 second. And the pitch on the way. Ball game. And that's going to be it. 3-2 is going to be your final score. The Red Bay JV coming from behind and getting a win as a wave to the Belgrade Lady Bulldogs. So Red Bay, a nice little sweep today. The JV winning 3-2. The varsity win 6-5. Don't forget the Red Bay Tigers back in action right here, softball. Thursday as Russellville comes to town. The Tigers will be in Russellville on Friday and Saturday. I'm sure if you'll check out, they'll be posting what time they play and all that stuff Friday and Saturday. But an honor to have you on the broadcast. Coach Rogers, thank you for your help. Enjoyed it. Yes, sir. We're going to say goodnight to you. May God bless you. Once again, I'm Jack Ivey saying thank you for joining us. The Red Bay Tiger baseball teams lost it big time today, 15-0 down at Sulgit. Scott was on the call down there. And, of course, we'll have that on TV later for you. But tonight we'll be replaying, of course, the softball games right here. Two very, very good games. Once again, Red Bay winning the varsity game 6-5, winning the JV game by a score of 3-2. And that is going to wrap up our broadcast. Thanks to our wonderful sponsors that made the games possible here today. Thank you, Piggly Wiggly, on our sponsorship today. I'm Jack Ivey saying thank you for joining us. May God bless you. We'll see you next time right here. For more Red Bay Tiger sports on the Ivy Broadcasting Company, and good night from David Tiffin Field, and thank you, Scotty James, for checking in with us.